Hello everybody and welcome to today's Sunday sermon, which is the 27th Sunday in ordinary time. During the time of Jesus, we know that the Jewish people rejected him. Of course, some did accept him, but generally speaking, he was rejected. And of course, he was handed over to be crucified. Today's vineyard story is Jesus' way of telling the Jewish listeners at the time, this is what you're doing to the Messiah. You're waiting for the Messiah. He has come, and now you're going to reject him and throw him out and kill him. The danger for us looking at this today is to exonerate ourselves from any blame and not see that we too reject Jesus. We throw him out of the vineyard. And I can't even go as far as to say we kill him through our sinfulness, through our forgetfulness, our lack of belief, our unwillingness to practice our faith because it's too difficult. So today we must look into our souls, into our hearts, and see where we too are like the Jews, rejecting Jesus in our behavior and in our feeble efforts at being Christian. We are rejecting Jesus in the same way as the Jewish people when we continue to sin, or when we don't practice our faith as we should, when we forget to pray, we don't believe in it, when we don't look at the Bible, when we fill our minds with wrong kind of thoughts and wrong ideals which are contrary to the gospel, then that's when we are rejecting Jesus. We are throwing him out of the garden or out of the vineyard in the same way. Now, the vineyard is our life as we find it. Each and every one looking on here has their own vineyard, in the sense it's where you are at this time and the people you're with and the situation you're in, the part of the world you're in, the challenges. Now and again, we are being challenged. We are being challenged, like the people who are coming to collect the produce or the proceeds of the vineyard. We are sent people who remind us of how we should be acting as good Christians. Maybe our enemies, we are failing to forgive them. In so doing, we are kicking Jesus out of our garden as well, out of the vineyard that we occupy. The same way with people who come to advise us. If we don't go to Mass and read the Bible, we have no direction. We have no something that we can judge our life from. Like, the Bible it's like a mirror. It shows us who we are if we really read it in the right way. So if we don't practice those things, then we are rejecting Jesus in the same way as the Jewish people are those people in the vineyard when they threw all out of the vineyard and wanted to take over and live their own lives, very similar to ourselves. Going back to the garden with Adam and Eve, they didn't want God. They didn't want God to be in charge. They wanted to be greater than God. The tree of knowledge would make them greater than God. This is what they believed, and this was the temptation from the devil. Mr. William Barclay, in his daily study of the Bible, wrote, There are things in this world which are flippant and cheap and attractive to the light-minded. But it is on the things which are serious and dignified that the Christian will set his or her mind. He also said and wrote that there are those whose minds are set on vengeance, punishment, reprisal, and they fill their minds and hearts with bitterness and this kind of evil and spread it all around them. While as the Christian dwells on forgiveness, letting go and being healed of the hurts, not holding on to it, wanting to be healed and wanting to love even our greatest enemy. Paul even goes further than that. He tells the Philippians to copy what they have heard and seen in himself. He's putting himself up as an example to follow. How many of us are willing to do that? Am I willing to do that? Okay, guys, look at what I do. Don't listen just to what I say. Look at what I do. Am I willing? Are we willing? As Christians, all of us are called to do that, to be the example to others. As Christians, when troubles come our way, are we a good example to others? How we accept our crosses, our troubles, death, sickness, poverty, disappointments? Or are we just devastated by these events? Are we able to be a great example to the non-believer who can say, hey, look at how valuable it is to be a believer? That's what's been encouraged of us today. And that's what Paul said, look at me. Can we set ourselves up in this way? Priests, bishops, teachers, catechism teachers, churchgoers, everybody who proclaims to be a Christian really should be able to say, look at me and do as I do. And then in the other challenges of the poor and those who are isolated and alone, how do we look after them and care for them? It's in these practices of how we show love to them and concern and encouragement to the downtrodden. That's when people see that we are Christian. It's in those areas and in those times, more than anything. Not so much being seen every day in church, even though that's great, but it is in that kind of action, that sort of love that we practice in our lives with our fellow human beings. Also, the way we forgive those who hurt us. And if you do good at all, it's almost a fact of life. You will have people who will hate you. Forgive them. It doesn't matter. But don't just throw them away and cast them away as lost forevers. No, pray for them. Pray that they may come back. So today, we pray that we are able to see more and realize that we too act like the people in today's vineyard by our sins, and especially when we don't see the need to practice a definite and sure Christian way of life. I would like to finish with a positive note. I believe you who have taken time to watch this video are well on the way to being great and saints. You have in you more than you think. Even you have great faith, only that it may not have been tested. And life will test it, as we know. And when the troubles of life come, it's amazing what we find deep down there. You've got it. Don't ever doubt that. Blessed are those who suffer, because they are closer to God. They have more of a chance of finding the God we are speaking of. And we are assured God will never let us down. May God bless you to have a beautiful day and a pleasant week ahead, filled with God's graces.